Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ, and we start out this episode in season 3 preseason, but I have an announcement to make. Marvin Jones is now a superstar X Factor. 2 seasons in, it took a top 5 wide receiver year in season 1 and a top leader in catches in season 2 to get him to this status. I am fired up about this. I mean, it's. I didn't think it would be possible to get one of these guys a superstar X Factor, but we did it here going into season 3. So I do want to kind of recap the offseason for other teams. I want to start with a couple of teams that are kind of looking like us. The Bengals are stuck in the same situation that I think we were stuck in last year. They have Andy Dalton signed to a 1-year deal. One more year left on his contract, and I think they're going to be rebuilding. And I did trade for the Colts pick last year because I thought they would be rebuilding. We'll take a look at them as well. Kirk Cousins transitions over to the LA Rams after being on the Vikings. And wow, this is a change because Jared Goff, remember, got that big $200 million contract from the LA Chargers. I keep thinking San Diego Chargers, but he is a number 5 rated quarterback as far as overall goes, and he's got a ton of weapons, including Laviska Shenault, who came out of Colorado, 21 years old. I think they're pretty much set because he might be a superstar development because he does have a hidden dev trait right now. So it's going to be interesting to see this team and see how they build. Sticking in that same division, remember the Chiefs went 6-10 last year, and Mahomes was pretty good, but wow, the Chiefs took a step back in that division. Lamar Toll is a second-year running back. He's their weapon on offense, you know, kind of that Kareem Hunt type of guy that they were missing, and he ran for 842 last year, only a 3.3 average. So sticking in the AFC, I'd mentioned that I did get rid of Andrew Luck off of the Colts. I just switched him to punter, so it forced them to cut him. They picked up Jordan Love, and Jordan Love was one of the quarterbacks I was looking at in this year's draft. He was actually the guy I wanted to draft, but the Colts scooped him up maybe like a few picks before we even got to draft him, and I was going to take him. Trust me, I think this was going to be one of the quarterbacks I was going to build and see what I got out of, but ended up not working out. He ended up being decent. So Jeffrey Skillen was the offensive rookie of the year in the NFC, and that kind of sucks. And the reason why is because now that means Daniel Jones is just going to kind of be sitting behind him until his contract is up. And I kind of wanted to see what Daniel Jones would develop into in this game. And I think they came into Madden rating him pretty low, and it's, I mean, for good reason. We didn't really know what Daniel Jones is going to be until we saw him in the preseason, and that guy is going to be special. Now, I ended with the Patriots. They signed Phillip Rivers to a 1-year deal and then drafted Tua at the end of the first round, I believe that was. It wasn't the second round. I think it was the first. I believe it was at the end of the first round. And look at them. I mean, this is a team that's definitely going to kind of be rebuilding if they don't do anything with Phillip Rivers. And who knows? He might get a contract extension, so Tua might be stuck behind him. But I think they might move on from Phillip Rivers. It's just a 1-year deal, so we'll see. So our preseason schedule looks like this: the Buccaneers, Redskins, Bears, and Packers. I wish that Madden would make it so that you can't play divisional opponents in the preseason, but I guess that's just how it goes. We also play the Tampa Bay Buccaneers here in the preseason and the Redskins. The Redskins, we actually open up with them, so I won't be playing them. So I'm going to play the Buccaneers and the Packers because we don't play the Packers until week 11 in the regular season. So looking at D Bird, this is interesting. So the Bucks did draft him last offseason in the first-year player draft, and they actually already have Jameis locked up, which is really interesting. Bird is actually a superstar X-factor quarterback, so they have 2 quarterbacks on their roster that, I mean, are starters. I mean, to be honest, Jameis is a starter. Bird is a starter. I mean, I don't know what they're thinking there in Tampa Bay, but I don't know. Bird maybe might be an option for us to trade, but I know it's very difficult to trade for superstar X-factors in this game. So if things don't work out with the quarterbacks we have, I don't know. It might be an option, maybe even to go after Jameis, but I don't like that contract that he has. Too much money for me. So here we go. Playing this first preseason game, you want to see what this defense kind of comes out looking like, and here's a throw across the middle to Mike Evans, Jameis' favorite target. That's a big first down. So what I want to see out of this defense, really, our first round pick, Rich Patton, he's going to be right in the middle. You see me controlling him right here as I'm on a third and four. Jameis drops back, throws across the middle, and it's going to be broken up. Big play, Slay and Patton. I think that's one of the things I like about Patton. He has about 87, 88 speed. I forgot exactly what it is, but he's going to be playing a big role in the middle of that defense. It's a lot easier to use or a faster linebacker. So out comes Anthony Ying. He gets his chance at starting quarterback at just 58 overall. I know this is a fan favorite guy, and he's going to have a longer leash, I think, because he was sitting back behind Stafford last year. His first throw of preseason is a 10-yard reception to Marvin Jones, the new superstar X-Factor. As we do hand it off to Kerryon Johnson, I'm expecting a big year from our running game, especially with Travis Etienne there. He's going to be a difference maker, and also Kerryon's going to look to make that year four leap and get to that next contract. We'll see, because he's going to be due for one this season. So Hockenson does get open on the sideline, followed up on a second and eight. Here's a play action fake, pump fake, and it's going to be a sack. I actually meant to throw that. I did not mean to pump fake that, so my bad. Loss of about 7 to 8 yards on that. So now a third and 15 at the 38-yard line. Throw to the sideline. It's going to be caught by Wallace, and Tylan Wallace is going to be that slot guy for us. He gets his first reception of preseason, as we do have a new kicker, Bryant, as he does line up for the long field goal, and his meter actually goes a little bit faster than Matt Prater, and it's something to get used to. Don't worry, I'm working out the kinks. I do miss that one, but I'm getting used to his meter. Like I said, it's a lot different kicking with him and Matt Prater. So out on the next possession, here is Jameis Winston still in the game. Let's see if our defense can come up with another stop. Here's a throw across the middle. That's O.J. Howard across the middle. And that is a first down inside the 5-yard line as they line up under center here. Pitch play out to the left side. And look at that block. He blocks two guys on the same play. I don't think I've ever seen that. Both of them get pancaked by one guy, and they're in for the touchdown. That's their running back, Rowe, and he makes it 7-0. So here is Ying back out onto the field, throwing the ball across the middle on a slant pattern, and that's a third down and short, as now we get it to a fourth and two. Ying, quick throw across the middle. Hockenson, it's the preseason. I'm going for it on those four downs. Usually I wouldn't, and it's a first down. So now at the 35-yard line, third and nine. Once again, here's a throw across the middle. That's Hockenson holding on to it in traffic, taking a big hit. But it's a first down here as we move the chains close to the 46. So here's the thing with Anthony Ying. He doesn't have the greatest throw power, and I need to throw into these lanes like that one, but that one was a bad throw. That's an interception on the left side of the field, and that's intended for Marvin Jones. And that's the thing. The one thing about playing with Anthony Ying is his balls get deflected at the line quite a bit, and that height is definitely a deterrent for me to, like, run a lot of pass plays because, like I said, those deflections definitely deflate the offense, and it's kind of like a loss of down because it's like didn't even give your receiver a chance to catch the ball. It's a deflection at the line. So we do bring in Easton Stick. I want to see what he's got. He is a mobile quarterback. He's about 85 speed. He ran, I believe they ran kind of like a, maybe not a triple option exactly, but it was a style of offense that featured kind of a running quarterback. As you see here, he's taking off. And look at the speed. This is what I'm saying. Look at that. Wide open field. He picks up a gain of 22. That would be a definite weapon. And even if he doesn't come into season three starting, I think he's definitely going to get in on kind of quarterback design runs. As here's Jamal Williams getting his first big carry of the season here. And I'm going to be looking for Jamal Williams to be in kind of late in games as kind of our power back, the guy that kind of has to hold on to the ball, because you know that Kerryon Johnson has had fumbling issues here in this franchise, and I just want to kind of get another guy back there that can hold on to the ball. But here's a throw out to the left side. That one was intended for Deontay Burnett, and it's deflected as we move on to the second half here. Anthony Ying, I'm putting him back in for the third quarter and then probably putting back Easton Stick for the fourth. I guess we'll see. So under center, here is Ying. Throw across the middle, and that's what I'm talking about. That height, he really can't make all the throws, and that's going to be kind of why I'm going to be throwing to the outside quite a bit, because I need to throw into lanes that, you know, the defenders aren't at, the defensive line isn't there to deflect, and that's Equanimeous St. Brown. He's going to get some burn this year, and I am turning injuries up, so really depth is going to matter more, and here is our late round draft pick. That's Brooks from Oklahoma getting in. He's one of the hidden depth trade guys. Here's Travis Etienne. Look at the burst. His first big carry. And he's getting up the middle for about a gain of 15 on that one. And that's the thing about Etienne. He's got the explosiveness that maybe Kerryon Johnson doesn't have. Kerryon Johnson's more of the all-around back. Here's a throw to the left side, and that was a throw we were trying to make earlier, and that's caught by Equanimeous St. Brown that time as we get it to the 20-yard line. And we line him here to go for it on a 4th-and-4. Why not? Here is Ying in the pocket trying to get rid of it, but he gets hit on the throw, and it's a sack by Nelson as we move on here to the end of the game. We end up losing this one 27-6. I just kind of wanted to get my feet wet with this offense. Anthony Ng ends up throwing 3 interceptions in this game, and some of those weren't me. I didn't play the whole entire game, so he does take the sack. We did throw 1 interception. Easton Stick actually threw an interception as well. As Travis Etienne, I really like that burst. As you saw in that handoff, that's a kind of a run play up the middle that Kerryon Johnson would not break for a big gain, and I'm excited for the home run ability of Travis Etienne in this offense. Also, Brooks. Brooks isn't a fast guy like Etienne, but I think that those 3 guys and even Jamal Williams, I think I'm going to carry 4 backs because I'm going to need it. I'm going to need that depth. So we do have a mentorship scenario that comes up with Quinn Bryant, once again, our number 1 draft pick last season. So he's going into his second season here with the offense, and he gets a +3 and run block finesse from Kyle Long. So I guess Kyle Long, that signing ended up paying off a little bit early. And then he gets another upgrade. So he's a really good pass blocker right now. I'd say he's actually pretty balanced. And that's the one thing I like about Quinn Bryant. And I think this is why our offense is going to be really good running the ball, because our young offensive linemen are actually coming in pretty good, as Quinn Bryant has pretty much went up 6 overall since we drafted him, and he's a number 10 ranked left guard in the league. He's got a lot of potential here, as we do have an upgrade for Jelani Tavai. In season 1, he was the rookie of the year, and he's going to be looking to build off of that going into season 3. So now we decide to sim that next game versus the Washington Redskins, and the reason being is because we are playing them in the opener. I don't want to spoil it playing them twice, so I do end up simming this game and giving Easton Stick the start. And take a look, Easton Stick in a start goes 200 yards, 2 touchdowns, no interceptions, and look at Ying. He struggles again. His second straight game with 3 interceptions, it's not looking good to start out for Ying. We want to kind of give him a chance, though. I'm not sure if we'll go with Ying or Stick yet. And I got to say, Stick looks better. And I want to play the fan favorite, though. I do want to give him a chance. And like I said, this isn't a year we're thinking about winning a Super Bowl at any means. And maybe we end up competing for a playoff spot. And that's the goal. I want to compete for a playoff spot at least. Rich Patton, the rookie, gets a sack and he has a big game. But take a look. After the game, we get some bad news. A dislocated knee, and he's going to be out for 5 weeks. So he's probably going to miss the first and or second week of the season. And that kind of sucks because, remember, he is a hidden depth trait, 21 years old, a rookie out of Texas A&M. He was our number 1 pick at pick 12 in the draft. And I think this guy's got a ton of potential. Now, speaking of potential, Sean Chapman led our team in sacks last year with 6. I'm definitely looking for him to make that year 2 leap once again. He had a great rookie season. Actually did finish in, I believe, the top 7 in rookie of the year voting in the NFC. So that's pretty good. I gotta admit, that's pretty good. Anthony Ying gets an upgrade, and this is what I'm hoping that will happen. If we do end up playing him, he'll just keep progressing. I'm hoping for about a 6-8 overall boost for him. His overall, his XP goes up to 2,300 to upgrade. Last year, it was about an 1,800 XP to upgrade, but he's looking pretty good right now. So we do sim the next game, and it's versus Chicago, so I don't want to play another divisional game, and we're playing them early on in the season, and we end up winning. But we don't just end up winning. We beat the brakes off of the Bears. I mean, look at this. They gained 155 yards of total offense, and we gained 454. And the reason why this is significant, because this was the third preseason game, the game where the starters played the most, and we actually did really well. I think they took either Trubisky out or he got hit. But still, we were playing against their number one defense, and we did numbers like this. Easton Stick got the start once again. Anthony Ying did not play in this one. Mason Fine, our fifth-round draft pick, played in this one. And Kerryon Johnson had a big game. This is what I was looking for out of him. He had 83 yards, and they pretty much played the first half. But look at Tylan Wallace. 9 receptions out of the slot. He gets a touchdown. Hockenson, he gets a touchdown. Big game from him. And even Marvin Jones and Deontay Burnett each got a touchdown. So I think this offense is looking pretty good. I really like Tylan Wallace there in the slot. I think he's going to progress quite well. And he's only 20 years old. Just remember that. A 20-year-old rookie is definitely unheard of. And you know, that reminds me of Robert Woods. Robert Woods is in his mid-20s. People forget, he's been in the league for like 6 years, and he's only like 26 years old. That's what I'm hoping, how that this Tylan Wallace career will go. I kind of like that trajectory of kind of a guy that's going to be still good in his mid-20s. I believe Tylan Wallace has a chance to be elite in this franchise. And Marvin Jones is superstar X-Factor, but he's going to be aging. So hopefully he ages well and Tylan Wallace steps up in that kind of that next tier of Lions wide receivers, great wide receivers. So here we go. We are going to play this next game versus Green Bay. Yes, it is a divisional game, but we don't play them, like I said, until after week 10. So it's going to be a while till we even play them again. So here's a throw across the middle. Rodgers in the game. He's going to find his receiver Weiss on that one. And Weiss was one of those guys we were looking at out of UCF in season one. And Rodgers looking good early on. Here's a throw to the left side of the end zone. He's got Devontae Adams. And that is going to be a touchdown for the Packers. We are in the rain, so I do want to kind of take it easy. And I do have injuries on. And the reason why is because I thought about turning injuries off in the preseason, but I do want to keep it realistic because injuries, yes, they do happen in preseason. And I just want to get a look at some of these guys as we try to run the ball this time to the left side. Easton Stick does get the start in this one as well. And I do want to see what I see out of Stick. And here is a draw play to the left side. And these are the type of plays we're going to be trying to run with Stick. I think he's got a lot of potential. I also think that I want to progress Ying as well. So I have no idea who I want to start. But here's a throw across the middle, wide open. That's going to be Tylan Wallace in man coverage. Man, that was a lot of separation on that route. And Wallace, if he can separate on routes like that, it's going to be fun to play with him. So here is Stick scrambling up the middle. He's got legs. Like I said, it's going to be such a weapon. He gets inside the 5-yard line. So here's a handoff to the right side. Carry on. He's getting to the outside, and this is what I wanted to see, a nice drive put together versus a first-team offense as we have a new quarterback at the helm, Easton Stick, and either him or Anthony Ying. I don't think Mason Fine is really going to play unless the other two just stink it up. And here's Jamal Williams with a carry up the middle versus his former team. That's a gain of 14. I do kind of want to get your guys' thoughts on the quarterback competition here because, like I said, Stick looks good because he can scramble, but Ying has kind of been the fan favorite, and he's kind of one of my favorites as well. I just want to see the progression from him, and who knows, it might be one of those undrafted stories where we start with a guy that's 50s overall, ends up, I don't know, sometime in his career, maybe in the 80s, who knows, but I'm trying to take this as many seasons, and I'm having really a lot of fun playing this Lions series. Mainly because of the overall gap. I really like it. You have to kind of grind to get these guys, you know, to be elite. And here is Travis Etienne. You see the burst on those carries up the middle. I'm really excited. He reminds me a little bit of Ezekiel Elliott. The way he just gets the ball, he just hits the hole. Look at that. That's a touchdown. That middle linebacker had no time to even get to Etienne in the hole. He's just quick. And that is another touchdown here for the Lions. So our defense, it's going to be like our second and third team defenses, so they do give up a couple of scores as we do take our starters out. And I want to see what Easton Stick has with kind of the backups, playing with lesser, you know, lesser, I guess, teammates on the field. I want to see what he's got. Here he is scrambling up the middle on a 3rd and 10. Look at the room and the speed. He's going to make it inside the 5. And he's a guy that can break tackles, so I will be sliding with him, you know, protecting him a little bit if he does end up getting in, he will. I think him both and Ying will both get in, and I think that this offense is going to be really good as you just see the potential out of this offense, especially with Stick and running the ball. I think it's going to be fun, and I think that, you know, Easton Stick does look impressive. I don't play Ying in this game because I don't want to risk that injury, because I think even though Stick looked good, you guys are going to say I'm crazy, but I just want to give him a chance. You know, in real life, it's kind of like the Eli Manning and Daniel Jones thing. You kind of want to give your starter the chance, give Stick, he's new in the offense, kind of give him time to, you know, get acclimated and give Ying a chance. I do want to just give Ying a chance. He didn't look good in the first two games, throwing 6 interceptions in preseason, but I do kind of want to just give him a chance at starter, and I think I'm leaning that way. I can be persuaded. So if you guys truly think that maybe Easton Stick should be the starter and Ying should not have a chance, but I just want to give Ying a chance, and it's kind of the, you know, I do want to see what he has with star development too. Maybe I can even get that up to superstar. That would be amazing there, an undrafted guy making it to superstar development. So let's go over our opening roster, our 53-man roster. And a couple of these guys are going to change because I did have the undrafted free agent profiles. I had that poll out on the community tab, so I had you guys submit some guys. I already got them picked out. Just need to put them in the game. But I am impressed by Tylan Wallace. I think that guy was getting open quite a bit in preseason, and it's going to be fun. Even in sim games, he had a big game at that 88, I believe, yard game on 9 receptions. That was pretty good, and I think he's going to be lethal in the slot as long as he can stay healthy. And I do want to pick up another wide receiver, probably one of these undrafted guys. I want to see what I got out of them. So our offensive line, I am going to start Kyle Long at right guard, but since we did draft 2 offensive linemen, I can easily see myself trading Long to a team that needs a guard and possibly get a good draft pick out of him. I'm thinking like a 3rd-round pick. I think that'd be good to get from him. I'm really looking for the year from Samson Ebukam. He's going to have a really big season for us. Patton is going to be out for the first couple of weeks, but Ebukam's going to need to play big because I'm looking for him and Trey Flowers to definitely add to this pass rush and be a force. Tim Jackson. Remember, he was an undrafted guy last year. He is going to make the opening day roster, and he is going to make a difference, along with undrafted defensive tackle last year, Nico Ace. Nico's going to be in quite a bit because Snacks Harrison is gone, so you're going to definitely see some of these undrafted guys get some burn. So looking at our schedule, we will be playing the NFC West this year and the AFC North. So we will be playing the Seahawks, Steelers, 49ers, Rams all in a row. That's a tough, tough 4-game stretch for us, especially since the Seahawks are the defending world champions. And then we end the season playing the Ravens, and the Cardinals are a little lesser, but who knows how good they are. So Ezekiel Elliott update. He is signing with the division rival Redskins as we go up against them week 1, but look, he's out with a broken toe. So we dodge a bullet here. We will not have to play Zeke in week 1, but he is going to be with the Redskins. Who knows? He might get a contract extension from them, but this is what happened. He signed with the division rivals. I guess I wouldn't want it any other way because it seems like all the NFC East guys just go to their division rivals, which is pretty cool, actually. But the one question from the Redskins, we will go up against them in week 1. Who will start at quarterback? Jake Fromm was drafted number 1 overall. He's a hidden dev guy. I'm pretty sure he's going to be superstar or superstar X Factor. And then Dwayne Haskins, who I don't know. I mean, he's pretty good. I don't know why they went quarterback here. They had their quarterback of the future in Haskins, but they decided to go that route. So week 1. Will be next episode. We'll get to see either Dwayne Haskins or Fromm at quarterback, and we will get to see a lot of new faces on our offense, Tylan Wallace and either Ying or Stick, probably both on offense as well, and a couple of new starters on defense. So that's going to do it here in this episode. I kind of want to give you guys a sneak peek at how this team is going to look and who made the roster, and I think this is going to be a fun season. So hit subscribe, hit that like button, stay tuned. Let's get it. Let's go.